I downloaded LibreOffice from the LibreOffice.org website. On their homepage, I clicked Download LibreOffice, and I'm running Windows 7 64-bit. On their downloads, I went to where this check mark is, downloaded LIB for LibreOffice version 3.3.4, Windows x86 install multi.exe. Downloaded that, I just right-clicked and saved to file, double-clicked it, it was installed. After installing LibreOffice, we see an icon created on the desktop. To start it, we just double-click, and it opens up LibreOffice 3.3.4. In this series of tutorials, we want to use the text document, so I'm going to click that right now. And it opens up the LibreOffice Writer. The first look at the LibreOffice Writer, we see at the top of the window the title bar. The title bar shows the name of the document, in this case, Untitled 1, because we've not given it a name yet. And then on the right side of the title bar, we have our Minimize, Maximize, and Close Out the window. Below the title bar, we have the menu bar, which has commands and features in drop-downs that we'll be using throughout this tutorial series. Below the menu bar are the toolbars. Toolbars are often shortcut buttons to commands and features used most often in the menu bar commands. We can turn off and turn on the toolbars by going into View, Toolbars. I'm going to turn off the Find, which was right here. We'll see that come back when I turn it back on with View, Toolbars, and I'll click the Find back on. And it's back. Then we have a ruler across the top and on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, we've got a scroll bar. And at the bottom, we've got our status bar, which has page 1 of 1. And the other thing I want to point out at this time is a little scroll bar for zooming in and out. We'll get to the rest of all this in future tutorials. While moving the mouse over the menu bar and toolbars, we have an arrow. But when it gets over the document area, it turns into an I for insert. When I click in the document area, we see a cursor flashing. That's where I'm going to insert my text. Because there's nothing in there yet, we're in the upper left-hand corner. Another thing I want to show right away is this non-printing characters. If I click that on, it shows this funny-looking character. That means end of paragraph. All of the LibreOffice Writer documents are going to end with an end of paragraph character. So I have that on there. I'm going to turn that off. Every time I click I, it's only right at the upper left-hand corner. We must start all text there. So this, is some sample text. Now I can click anywhere in my text and the marker, the insert, goes there. And that's a first look at the LibreOffice Writer.